It's Monday, December 6, 2021. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for your journey today. Our devotion today is entitled, Aching Bones and Hopeful Hearts, and our scripture is Romans chapter 8. Paul writes, "For we know that all creation has been groaning as in the pains of childbirth right up to this present time. And we believers also groan, even though we have the Holy Spirit within us as a foretaste of future glory. For we long for our bodies to be released from sin and suffering. We too wait with eager hope for the day when God will give us our full rights as his adopted children, including the new bodies he has promised us. We were given this hope when we were saved. If we already have something, we don't need to hope for it. But if we look forward to something we don't yet have, we must wait patiently and confidently." When your body is in pain, that pain can radiate to your mind and your spirit and soul. That is true of all humans, and so is the inverse. When your soul has joy and hope, it will radiate to the body. You're probably familiar with the children's ditty, "If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands, stamp your feet, tell your face." That last part isn't in the kids' song. I added it to make this point. Let the joy inside you tell your body so your body can radiate joy outside you. The Apostle Paul was making a similar but seemingly contradictory point. Not nature's way, but a spiritually sound principle of Christian doctrine and eternal truth. And that truth is, although our bodies, our bones, ache for release from the deadness of sin, that which is alienation from our Creator, the hope that resides in our inner being, our heart, is so steeped in the confidence of hope in Christ, the ache and hope pump together like systolic and diastolic measurements. They pump life into despair, joy into darkness, and out comes lightness to the soul. The hope of Christ's glory within our being counteracts anything Satan throws at us. It's no secret that some of us wear our feelings on our shirt sleeve. Those folks make terrible poker players. They couldn't bluff their way out of a paper bag. Then there are those who hide it like a master. They stuff everything, good or bad, deep down into compartments where they never have to meet with each other. It's a protection device humans develop to avoid pain. It isn't a new thing that Freud or Jung discovered. It's so old we read about it in the opening pages of Scripture. Adam and Eve messed up and God confronted them. They both tried to shift responsibility to anywhere but owning it. The result was the motherlode of dysfunction. Their children picked up on this and took it to the next level when Cain killed his brother Abel. We do anything to avoid facing the pain caused by our own actions. That's why Paul wrote that we ache, literally we agonize, for the day when we'll be released from all that internal conflict and pain. As in all of nature, a need presupposes something to meet that need. A void has air to rush in, like opening a sealed can of nuts. Psst. Thirst presupposes there's water to quench the need. And the ache in your inner conflicted being, which is caused by the separation you feel from your Creator, a result of that first step away from God's will, that presupposes the existence of salvation, God's forgiveness and restoration, which are truly one and the same. For you today, do your bones ache for release? How about the heart? Are you in Christ, trusting his offer of grace and forgiveness? Let those two realities out of their hiding places. Let them meet without fear. Let the Christ in you become all your spirit needs to grow strong and radiant. Aching bones and a hopeful heart are the ingredients to mix together for an overcoming life. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.